The Newsroom.
Welcome back. You're still watching The Newsroom and The Notice Board. My name is Victoria Namtewi.
And I'm Desire Derek Ford Mugumisa.
Now, Bunyoro Kingdom is yet again under the spotlight over the Bugoma Forest Reserve.
Now, National Forestry Authority accuses the kingdom of illegally involving themselves in giving away over 8,000 hectares of this forest reserve to investors.
The area under concession is Muhangazme Block Compartments MU7, MU8, MU10 and MU11, which run through the sub-counties of Changwali, Kabuya and Chizurafumbi in Buhanguzi County in the Oil Rich District of Hoima. Last month, NFA, backed by the Environment Police, moved to stop investors from illegal cutting, clearing and destruction of part of the forest in the Bugoma Central Forest Reserve in Hoima District, accusing Bunyoro Chitara Kingdom of unlawfully reclaiming 8,000 hectares of the reserve and selling it to an investor attached to Bunyoro Sugar Works for sugarcane growing.
We stepped in as National Forestry Authority to stop the clearing of the forest reserve by the investor who claims to have been allocated or leased land in that part of the forest reserve. And as we speak, there's no further activity taking place in that particular location.
Despite the fact that many direct witnesses know that they are the one committed in expansion of sugar cane plantations, he denied to me. And he said it's not true, and he said that he does not have any claim over Bugoma Forest. He even denied that the two graders went there to grade are theirs.
Speaking to media in Kampala, the spokesperson of NFA, Gilbert Kadilo, confirmed that a boundary opening exercise was ongoing, and at the moment they are holding discussions with the kingdom to solve the matter amicably. Bunyoro Kingdom claims they have cultural sites in the forest reserve.
We shall continue to engage with the kingdom of Bunyoro Kitara over the matter. As we said, there is, as a resolution of the last meeting between the different parties, an agreement to constitute a joint team that will help find a solution to this problem.
NFA anticipated an impending catastrophe if all stakeholders don't wake up against forest destruction. It is estimated that by 2015, over 80% of the forest cover on private forest land had been wiped, and that Uganda continues to lose 92,000 hectares of forest cover annually.
It is projected that at this state, at this rate of forest cover loss, in the next 20 to 30 years, Uganda may have no forests to talk about.
Bugoma Forest Conservation Association has organized a conservation walk themed Run for Nature to raise public awareness about the need to save Bugoma Forest and to call for an immediate stop to violence, illegalities and degradation. Pressure on forest reserves for agriculture, settlement, charcoal, timber and firewood remains a major reason as to why forests are disappearing. Plant a tree today to save the environment in the future. Report compiled by Juliet Namwaya for Urban TV.
Well, over now to our daily series of bad parenting, and tonight we focus on the unhealthy feeding. Although snacks, sweets and fast foods are the most affordable and convenient way for a parent to tame the cravings of their young ones, experts have warned against this bad parenting perception.
Now, according to Dr. Noleb Mugisha of the Uganda Cancer Institute, pastries and processed foods are a silent killer in children's bodies. Now, these are largely responsible for diseases such as obesity, diabetes, and cancer among children due to the fact that a number of tissues are affected by the artificial additives found in these foods.
While most parents would prefer to pack simple snacks like crisps, cereal or even a burger as breakfast for their toddlers to eat at school, many of these may be contributors to the most dreaded non-communicable diseases such as cancers, diabetes and heart diseases. According to experts, processed foods contain excess amounts of salt and fats, which are unhealthy. Processed foods and drinks are not only a form of malnutrition but also destroy body tissues due to the fact that they contain artificial flavors. Although most parents perceive this to be very good for their children, Dr. Noleb Mugisha of the Uganda Cancer Institute warns that these foods expose the children to diseases like diabetes, obesity, hypertension, among others.
Feeding our children on fast foods, I think, you know, when you talk about burgers, you talk about chips, chaps, and chicken deep fried, one, the biggest danger in it is that the child is trained to eat badly. You know, you're training a child to have bad eating habits, which ultimately will lead them, because that's a big risk to cancer. Like you heard in the presentation, that one of the four big risks for cancer, hypertension, and diabetes is actually bad eating habits.
Dr. Mugisha also points out a tendency of parents chewing food or traditional herbs and spitting them into the mouths of their little ones. This, he says, leads to the transmission of germs and viruses from the mother to the child.
Parents who actually chew food or medicine and spit in the mouths of their children, that can practically transmit a virus that we call human herpes virus 8 that leads to Kaposi's sarcoma. Kaposi's sarcoma is one of the common cancers in children who are suffering from HIV. And this virus, we've learned, children acquire it early in their lives through, you know, sharing saliva and body fluids with their parents.
A quick tour of kindergartens within Kampala will show you many children carrying simple bites like biscuits plus soda or bottled juice for their breakfast. This, as parents testify, is convenient for them as it helps them not to go through the hassle of preparing proper food for the children as they go to school.
A child would opt for gorillas than having either a mango or an orange or a banana.
The parents also affirm they are aware of the dangers of these foods, yet they continue with the habit.
And the diseases they cause, stomachache, and even the children don't grow very well.
Junk food can be appealing for a variety of reasons, including convenience, price, and its taste. For the children, who barely understand the health consequences of their eating habits, junk may appear especially appetizing. However, regularly consuming fattening junk food can be addictive for children and lead to complications like obesity, chronic illness, loss of esteem, and even depression, as well as affecting how they perform in school and extracurricular activities. For Urban TV, I'm Rachel Nachwala.
Well, there is a player with the mighty She Cranes who's looking forward to play for the She Cranes. That and many more stories coming up shortly on TNR Sport with Emmanuel Epenu. But before that, the Money Markets Report.
Hello, welcome to TNR Sport. I'm Emmanuel Epenu. Now, 19-year-old Angela Namirembe, a student and netball player of Nkumba University, has vowed to be a pillar in Uganda's netball team ahead of the second World University Netball Championships due next week in the United States.
Angela Mirembe will make her maiden appearance at the World Showpiece as she represents Uganda in the second edition of the FIS World University Netball Championships, slated from 13th to 17th July in Miami, Florida, USA. The 19-year-old defender pursuing a diploma in tourism at Nkumba University in her year one has set focus on using this championship to up her talent to the next level.
I'm looking at improving on my game. You know, I've been playing for high school games, you understand? Now it's on a new level. I'm in university, so I have to improve on my game. And my goal is to go on the Uganda national team.
Uganda is pulled alongside giants Jamaica, Great Britain, and Australia. However, Namirembe is confident the team has what it takes to compete.
We are prepared. We've been training since. So now She has been like for 1 month. Yeah, she has been 1 month like serious training. Like the drills they have been giving us, I know we can do well.
The team has shifted their training from Nachivubo to Lugogo Indoor Arena to enable the players acclimatized to the surface. Team Uganda is expected to leave the country on Sunday before the week-long championships kick off on 13th of July.
Now moving on, Ndeje University's team of four athletes returned home yesterday after scooping 11 medals from the just concluded 8th edition of the All Africa Games in South Africa. Now the track and field team presented 7 gold medals, 3 silver and bronze to the university vice chancellor, Professor Eliabu Lukujo, and the sports tutor Paul Kayongo. Team captain Annie Chebet won 3 gold medals in both the 10,000 and 3,000 meter steeplechase, while Doka Sajok bagged 2 gold medals in both the 1500 and 800 meters. The only man on the team, Sadiq Bahati, won 2 gold medals in both the 5,000 and 10,000 meters as Prim Twichirize rounded up the team performance with 3 silver in the 5,000 and 10,000 and in the 5,000, 10,000 and 3,000 meter steeplechase. Ndeje University emerged third behind South Africa and Ghana, who finished first and second respectively. Now a total of 35 universities took part in the week-long event.
This is a very, very significant success. How on earth can you identify 4 people from the pack we have? And those 4 people go and excel to the uttermost. Is it by chance? Is it by cumulative practice or experience? This is left to decipher. But it is very, very important that we continue to train our athletes.
To be a motivator to the our upcoming athletes, since I've managed to scoop the 3 gold medals, I will also, I want to motivate the upcoming athletes also to be like me and they also get gold medals like this. And my goal is to be now in Olympics, or to scoop a gold medal in World University Games.
Well, that's your sport for this evening, but stay tuned to the newsroom. The latest headlines are coming up next.
This is the newsroom.
And before the notice board draws to a close this evening, let's take a look at the stories that made headlines.
Kampala lights up with Muslims' last-minute Eid al-Fitr shopping activity.
Makerere University Committee meets government over fees payment policy.
And police arrest man suspected to have caused the fatal Kampiringisa accident.
And that's it for the notice board this evening. Thank you for watching. The newsroom does continue at 9:10 p.m. Desire Derek Ford Mungumisa will be here with Alice Nanchinga, a cancer patient that needs your help. Make it a point to tune in and also offer a helping hand. But before that, at 9 p.m. we'll be having Tina Pierce with all the day's gossip. My name is Victoria Namtevi.
And I'm Desire Derek Ford Mungumisa. We're going to be taking a short break for now, but after the break, BBC Focus on Africa comes your way.